You're listening to
Catholic Sprouts,
the daily podcast for Catholic kids that strives to plant seeds of faith. Today's podcast is brought to you by OSV Kids, a magazine designed to help children grow in their faith throughout the liturgical year. To find out more, head to osvkids.com. Hey there, Sprouts. Today is Monday, July 26th, 2021. Today is also the feast day of the grandparents of Jesus Christ, Saint Anne and Joachim. Now, this week we are embarking on the fourth Beatitude, which is written, of course, in Matthew chapter 5, verse 6. So we will be talking about this. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be filled. So that's what we're talking about. And I know perhaps you don't understand that all the way. The word righteousness can be confusing, but don't worry. This is another great beatitude. And just to remind you, remember, this is also happy are those who hunger for righteousness, for they will be filled. So this is how we will be happy. And of course, it is a look at who Jesus Christ was. He hungered and thirsted for righteousness. So the first question that we need to answer here is, what does righteousness mean? It's not a word that we hear very often, probably not one that we use. Although it is a little bit more robust, the word righteousness we can replace with the word holiness. Holiness. So let's reread that one more time. It would be, blessed or happy are those who hunger and thirst for holiness, for they will be filled. So the big question with this beatitude is holiness the greatest desire of your life? And is it always that way? Are you always, first and foremost, really focused on being holy? On knowing God better, on being more like Him, on loving people better in the model of Jesus Christ? That is the question of this beatitude. And it is the question that all Christians must answer. Is God first? And do I love Him in a way where it motivates me to love other people too? That is the question of this beatitude. And so, before we get too deep into this, we're going to talk about our patron saints of the day, Saints Anne and Joachim, because although we don't know a ton about them, they remind us of something that we all have. So first of all, what we do know is that Anne and Joachim were the parents of Mary. We know that they were very devout. There are some traditions that say that they weren't able to have children, and that Mary was born sort of into their very old age when they had even given up hope of having any children. But Mary was born and she was their daughter. Now, whether they were alive for a long time, we don't know. But we do know that they were good practicing Jews and that they were looking for the Messiah, always filled with hope and confidence that God would be true to His word, that He would send the Messiah. So obviously, they were good examples and good parents for Mary. Now, what I want you to think about is I want you to think about your own role models in your family. And maybe, just like Jesus, you had very holy grandparents or even great grandparents. Grandparents and great grandparents are great examples very often in our lives of true holiness. One of the most holy women that I ever had the privilege of knowing was my Grandma Anne. My Grandma Anne was the mother of 10 children. She had a very hard, busy life on the farm. making bread, butchering chickens, doing all sorts of things. And yet, without a doubt, Christ was the number one pursuit of her life. She dedicated her life to Jesus. And let me tell you, the reason I know she loved Jesus so well, yes, I saw her pray hundreds of rosaries and go to Mass every day. I saw her do all of these things. But the real testament of her life was the way that she treated other people, both her children, people she knew, but also strangers. She loved them with the true love of Christ. She had a relationship with Jesus. She spent time with him and listened to him. And because he loved her so well and she received that love, she was able to bring that love to other people. And that is the true measure of holiness. Not only do I have a personal relationship with God, but does the love of God in that relationship spill over to other people? My Grandma Anne, even though she has died now, she remains the strongest example of holiness in my life. And I pray that whether it's your grandparents or a parent or a friend or a great aunt, that you have someone in your life that serves that model as well. And if you don't, we as Catholics have the whole congregation of saints, and they are more than happy to be your friends and your role models as well. You might have to learn about them in a YouTube video or a book, but they are happy to serve that role in your life. And so as we think about the great models of thirsting and hungering for holiness, let's recite these words from the Gospel of Matthew chapter 5, verse 6. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be filled.
That's it for Catholic Sprouts today. We'll be back tomorrow, but until then, continue to grow in your faith and truly sprout into the beautiful creation that God created you to be.
Just one more thing. We like to invite you to sign up for our weekly newsletter called the Domestic Church Bulletin. Totally free. Gives you an update on everything we're up to, exclusive discount codes for all of our sales that we offer exclusively to our subscribers, and lots of other fun Catholic family things that we're finding around the internet. Totally free to sign up. Simply check the notes for this podcast episode to find the direct link to sign up.
This show is a production of the Spoke Street Media Podcast Network. For more great podcasts, visit SpokeStreet.com.